attempted to contact cells beyond the Montrose area. It's hard to determine what's happening outside the wall, but our KPA sources report that several patrols have gone missing. And the ones that survived have nothing but horror stories. After the EMP went off, and the electronic grid that sustained us broke apart, our nation fell into a kind of a madness. I remember that first winter, desperation sweeping the country, people turned on each other, and worse, as food grew scarce. Many beyond the wall have no allegiance to any cause other than their own survival. If you must deal with them, be advised they can be unpredictable, and a fair number outright insane. Let's be careful out there. This is the voice of freedom.
The church is collapsing. Get out of there.
You're gonna have to jump.
Church is collapsing. Get out of there.
You're gonna have to jump. Grab the helicopter. Push through to us.
Tankers carrying jet fuel are nearing the Lake Tahoe area. Resistance operations are underway to intercept. Our soldiers need any and all resources we can provide to help them defeat the occupation. Use these encoded radio channels to communicate. I will, as always, be here as your conduit. This is the Voice of Freedom.
Garbage in these mountains. We've got about a 5 mile stretch to pull this off.
We hit him now. They can't call for help.
Right. We got
GPS signal from the transmitters. The convoy should be just up ahead. Tunnel ahead. Keep her steady, Jacobs. Fly straight through it.
Thank you. another on-ramp nearby.
I don't think these things were meant to go off-road.
Just follow my lead. Jacobs, cover us. We're gonna push through this neighborhood.
multiple SAM sites around the harbor.
Take him, cover me! down. This is Connor Morgan of the Montrose, Colorado Resistance. We have 3 fuel tankers to deliver to the U.S. Army.
Copy that. You're just in time. We've got a forward operating base set up in Sausalito. Meet us there. Over.
Roger. We'll arrive in 3 hours with air escort. Resistance out.
Once upon a time in America, our military was a well-oiled, well-funded machine capable of projecting massive power anywhere in the world. The crumbling of our nation, finished with the hammer blows of a cunning enemy, changed all that. But this country's strength has never been solely weighed by its guns and treasure. 250 years ago, farmers and shopkeepers, printers and blacksmiths fought a mighty empire, armed with little more than courage and a dream of freedom. Today, a new generation of civilians will join our armed forces to tear San Francisco from enemy hands. I am the voice of freedom, but you are its terrible, swift sword. This is a war of the people, by the people. Let freedom ring.
You guys are calling.